Hey, Mr. Black, just did the pack video, and this is for the one-legged Josh challenge. I wanted to do this. I was just gonna say, oh, this is a little axe I use in the backyard. Probably one of my most used tools here at the house, this little improvised axe. But I just didn't want to use something that I've had before. This needs to be re-lashed, and it's loosened up quite a bit. Well, it's pretty tight now, but this is just an edger blade, simple edger blade. Use the edge curbs, grass curb edge. So it's a spinning steel edger blade. Anyways, some of these can be pretty thick. They're great improvised tools right here, just by a little sharpening here. Anyways, if you cut them in half, if you have the way to cut them in half, you can make two functional blades. So you have the handle butt of one knife. This is the tip. All right, and then butt and tip. So you have the butt, tip, butt. If that makes sense, you cut it kind of in an S shape, and you get two nice pieces of steel for improvised blades. I have a bunch of videos on improvised blades, so I won't do another knife. But I didn't want to just use this one. Use it mainly through the winter, just splitting kindling and stuff. Like I said, I leave it in the yard, and it's one of my most used tools for digging out hackberry shoots and stuff like that. Not afraid of losing it. Ain't scared, but great tool. I saw a scab's axe, and I just came out of the deck area, my building area, with this. So, I don't know, double axe post, sorry. But this, like I said, is a good little tool I use around the thing. But I wanted to make something just for this post, so I went axe again. This sharpened it up pretty good. Basically used some 550 cord. This was that axe that I stuck in my hand, that little German hatchet. I needed to break it down. I'm going to do something else with that head. So this was in the yard. I kind of did a grab stuff within 20 feet drill and make something, and this is what I got. So I took the head off this handle actually last night, and the handle was still laying around. I always have a bunch of these. I actually made some wind chimes out of them at one time, and they kind of fell after the string rotted out. And that sounds terrible. Wind chimes out of edge blades, but you got to do what you got to do to make your environment pretty. So anyways, I've been wanting to make an Otzi axe. I have a piece of about a piece of copper rod I'm going to try to heat up and pound out, so that's on the go. Make a copper axe, but I didn't have the time to do that for this, so this is what I came up with. 550 cord, looped it through here again, Canadian jam, pulled that tight. Once that was tight, instead of tying a stopper knot, I just continued to wrap around here and then wrap around here to prevent it from splitting. I didn't flatten this edge out on this side, so there's a possibility if it moves backwards at all, it's going to cut through. So I haven't got to the fire part of this challenge, but I will soon, and I will use only this and probably a flint and steel. I did go out and split this, and I don't know if you can get this. This is just ash juniper, or what they call cedar, mountain cedar. Split this off of the log, and use this here. I'm gonna get in so much trouble. So, anyways, there's that. This is gonna be the tool for this video. So I'll put it back onto this this post right here, so I don't take up a bunch of space. Anyways, Mr. Black, I'm on it, trying to keep up with the challenges and stuff. Thank you very much for watching. Take care. Thanks, Josh, for this. This is a cool challenge. Might do a knife one too, just for the heck of it. And that's about it. Thank you very much. Mr. Black out.